Hi, welcome to Guy's Art Studio. Today we have a watercolour for you, slightly abstract, very loose. Hopefully it looks a little bit like oak leaves and branches with the light shining through. If you'd like to paint along with me, please do so. I'm using ultramarine blue, cobalt hue, cadmium yellow, cadmium red, alizarin crimson, and raw umber. And I start by drawing out just roughly some shapes of some leaves. So you could do oak leaves if you want, or some other tree, maybe a maple or something, it's up to you. Different shaped leaf, or even the shape of a flower. You start by drawing in just rough shapes that may or may not look like leaves, flowers. And if you split the paperwork with your eye up into thirds, so top to bottom in thirds and left to right in thirds, try and put something of interest along that third line or where the two lines cross over. Maybe top left, bottom right, maybe one, two or three of those positions. So here I'm wetting the paper, I'm cutting around the shapes of the leaves or the bits that I've drawn out that I do not want the watery watercolour to run onto. Laying down water onto the paper everywhere where I want the watercolour to go and where I want it to mix. Got a very watery ultramarine blue here and I'm dropping it in on top of the wet paper. I'm just dabbing it in here and there, making sure some of the paper is very light, very white. At the same time, adding in areas where it's darker. Making sure I've got some blended areas where it's dark to light, but I'm also making sure I've got some hard lined areas, maybe some places where it's dark against some dry edges of the paper to add a nice contrast. Wetting in between the leaf shapes, carefully cutting in between, following the pencil marks as best I can. So you don't have to cut in against all the pencil marks because some of those pencil marks will be cut in on the other side of the line with dark, maybe some yellow and some brown. Just adding some more blue in here, some darker watercolour, not quite as runny. Just have fun with this, it doesn't really matter where the paint goes. You don't really want the background colour maybe to go onto the leaf, so that's the only thing you've got to watch out for. If it does, it does. But it's not too tight a drawing. It's quite loose. Just have a bit of fun with it and move the paint around. This is your image that you're painting. You can't get it wrong. So I've just added some paint on here. The paper was a little dry because I hadn't wet this corner. This is a different technique. I've put a line on. I want to create some of those circles you get with photography. So you've got circles of light and it catches the light and it's unfocused. So I'm drawing some circles here now. They're going to be faint circles. Dabbing in some cobalt hue. It's a very free way to paint. Very unrestricted, very creative, and you can use your imagination. Get lost in it, get lost in the painting. Mixing some different blues now with each other. Mixing up a bit of alizarin crimson, dotting it in to the blues, trying to get some violets, some purple hues mixed in. The blues are still wet and they're doing their own thing. Splattering some very watery paint on top. Adding in some yellow now, some cadmium yellow. Very watery. I haven't dried the blue, so I'm keeping away from the blue. Just leaving a little bit of a gap, a little white edge. Thank you. Just add in a little bit more of the yellow, stronger mix into the watery yellow and letting it do its thing. Just trying to balance it up just a little bit here. Got quite a few yellows on the left. Let's add a little bit on the right. Add in a little bit more water and yellow. It's coming in with a hairdryer now, just drying it off as much as I can so that any of the paint that I add from now on doesn't mix with the paint that's already on the paper. It's quite fun to actually blow some of the paint around. To here, I've mixed a bit of cadmium yellow and cadmium red to make some orange, and I'm adding it on top of some wet cadmium yellow on the paper. It's picking out the shape of a leaf, or just picking out a shape that you might think is a leaf. Bit more watery yellow, a bit thicker. It's picking out the shape now. Try not to make sure it's identical to the other ones. Bring a variety to the shapes. We see here I can cut in a dry edge onto the blue, and because the yellow is wet, it's running and doing its own thing into the shape of the leaf. back to the hairdryer, dry it all off. Put my third lines on the outside on the masking tape so you can see where they cross over, making sure there's something of interest in the thirds. Adding a little bit more detail in now, put some raw umber on a brush, put a few twigs in. just adding a little bit more contrast to the background. And there we go, quite a simple little watercolour, doesn't take too long. It's lots of fun, there's lots of freedom involved with it. Try and keep some of those contrasting browns, reds, oranges against the blue. It'll bring the browns and the oranges closer to you and the blue will go into the distance. I hope you've enjoyed this. Hopefully you've painted along with me. You perhaps use your own colours and your own shapes of the leaves. Please press subscribe and like if you can, and check out some of my other videos. Thank you very much for watching Guy's Art Studio.